Welcome to my channel. The whole purpose that I'm here, aside from sharing fun, family, wholesomeness, because let's face it, I mean, you look at the news and you look around on different social medias and we need more wholesomeness in the world. Throughout my 43 years of life, I have had a multitude of spiritual experiences that have told me I know that there is life after this, and I am eager to share my experiences with you in case maybe you're wondering or have had that thought or that curiosity, is there life after this? And I am here to tell you, yes, there is life after this. So, like I said, there's a lot, so this will be over the course of quite a few videos, but I will get started with my very first one that I remember. Now, just to backtrack a little bit, when I was a child, I always felt spirits, and I lived in a home that was not good. So my experience with feeling spirits as a child was not something that I was comfortable with. I really didn't like it, so I kind of pushed that out of my being. When I was a teenager, I wasn't the best teenager, but I definitely wasn't the worst. But I would go out, I would sneak out of the house, I drank, I smoked weed, which, I mean, now that is more acceptable than it was then, but I wasn't using it for anxiety or for anything other than the simple fact of just getting toasted. So when I was 16, I had moved in with my dad for a little while, and my dad's girlfriend went ballistic on me one night. My dad was gone at work, and she got upset about, I have no idea what it was over. She just had some kind of like psychotic break, and she went to go grab knives and forks and any sharp object she could out of the drawers, and was coming in my room and was like, I'm going to kill you. I'm going to kill you. And so due to that, I moved in with my sister, who was LDS at the time. Her and her two children, my niece and nephew that I adore, and her husband. So I moved in with them, and they kind of taught me about the LDS church, and I was a little defiant against it. I was happy with who I was and what I was doing in life. But the more that I heard about it, the more that I learned, and the closer that I came to God, I realized that that was the choice I wanted to make. And so I got baptized when I was 16. In the LDS church, when you get baptized, you also get set apart as a member of the church. And with that, they urge you to fast and pray. And so you skip your meals for 12 to 24 hours, depending on your capabilities. I did a full 24-hour fast, and I felt so much clarity. I felt so much peace in my soul, and my spirit was just elated. Even when my sister said crap, I was like, oh my gosh, that hurts my spirit so much. And they made fun of me. My sister, my brother, they all made fun of me. They were like, it's crap, Amy, like, calm down. It's not, you know, some horrible word, but it hurt my spirit so much. And I remember thinking, you know, how sad it was that they were feeling like mocking me about it. But I also felt just love for them, you know, and I was like, you just say you don't understand. You don't understand where I'm at with my spirit right now. And that night I went to bed and I had a dream of what I can only describe as the second coming. And what had happened in the dream is we all walked outside, and there was just multitudes of people all out in the cul-de-sac at the same time. And they were just looking up, and down descended Jesus. And he was far enough from me that I could see and know who it was instantly, even though I couldn't see any details of who it was. Like, I just knew it was him. And I remember looking over in my dream and I was like, oh my gosh, it's Jesus. Like, I'm not ready for this. I'm not good enough. I was terrified in my dream that he was going to come to me and tell me all the wrong things I did or cast me aside because I am this imperfect human. And as he got closer and closer, I could just feel the love that he had for me and you and everybody. And he didn't, there were no words spoken in the dream at all, but the only thing that I felt was the most pure amount of love. And I knew then that that's what it's about. It's about love. That was my first experience with feeling that love. And I don't know if it was a premonition dream. I don't know if it was just a way for Jesus to connect with me and say, you're doing your best. I love you. You are imperfect, but I love you anyway. So that was my first experience, and it's something that has stuck with me throughout my entire life, and I can still feel that love that I felt in that dream. So I have a lot more experiences to share. This is one of many. So yeah, subscribe if you want to hear more. I hope to be able to help someone touch your heart, touch your soul. Don't forget to pray and have a blessed day.